So we have a 24 by 24. This is going to be a slab for a ranch style garage. We have the forms all laid out. These forms are a full 24 feet long, and we just screw them together. We'll square it up. We'll set transit grades to make sure we're perfectly flat. Then we'll hollow it out around the perimeter, plastic, rebar for a nice day. It's currently raining. So here we go. This job is about an hour away from where our shop is. So this is one instance where it really helps to pre-build ahead. We'll have all these done here in just a minute, all the walls. We've pre-cut the rakes, pre-built them, cut all the top plates, cut the truss spacers. We've done cut the angle bracing. Everything's cut ahead, anything possible that we can, except for plywood, roof plywood, and so on. But it probably represents, I don't know, 4 hours of travel time that we've saved by doing it this way. Plus, we have all the equipment set up in the shop, so all we have to do is plug in the compressor, and away we go. And here goes the walls. Ken's Carpentry, reporting live for the Weather Channel. We've got rain. We always run into something different on the job site. A little bit of haying going on. Just wanted to do a quick talk about shingles. The starters that go up the side of the roof, I usually cut them into basically five pieces. We'd start with a full shingle, and these are metric, so they're about 39 inches long. We cut 6.5 inches off of that one. This would be the first starter. Then I'd take another full shingle, cut 13 inches off, which is double of the 6.5. That would become the second one. And then a shingle basically cut in half, like that, become the third one. Then you use these other two, fourth and fifth one. Then on the very bottom, you use a full shingle. That way it staggers the shingles so that the water will shed down instead of underneath. Let me just show you on the other side of the roof how we did that. See how they stagger going up there. We're at the point where we have to finish drip edge and so on. Thank you. Now we'll roll out the ridge vent. Has a mesh on one side, not on the other, so this should be the side up. I usually roll it all the way out so you can get a good straight line on it. Nothing worse than a crooked line. Twenty-four by 24, two-car ranch style roof, complete. Let me just show you how the doors go. One-handed, they slide really well. Yeah.